YouTube, how you doing? Well, today I'm here with the Samsung Tab 2, the P5110, and we're gonna update it with the iPad X, in fact, the iPad 10 mod, okay? So, as we all know, this device is also known as the Espresso Wi-Fi, and it has official support from Lineage OS, really. And Lineage OS just updated, I think 2 hours ago, the latest version for this particular tablet, the Espresso Wi-Fi, the P5110. So this is only for the P5110. However, the mod that we're gonna flash on top of it will also work for other 10-inch tablets that also have root access and also have a custom recovery such as Turb or Clockwork mod, and running Android 4 up to 7. So it will all work, that mod, in fact, this is about the 5110, and this is my 5110, and I'm gonna, in fact, install the iPad 10 mod onto it right now. But first, of course, the Lineage OS that was just uploaded. So let's get started. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just connect the device to my computer, enable file transfer by pulling down the menu and then tapping the USB charging thing, and it will ask you what you want to do, and then you click on the middle one, you know, transfer files, and then I'm gonna put the Lineage OS that I download with my computer, I'm gonna copy it to the tablet, and I'm also gonna copy the latest mod that I kind of fixed for this device to the internal memory storage, and then we're gonna install it. So let's get started. Okie doke, welcome back. I just copied all the files to the device, and because I was kind of smart, I enabled the advanced reboot, and I'm gonna try to film it like this for you because the device is a bit big and it's also a little bit dirty, I see, but we will have to live with that. We should go into Turb. Ah, widescreen Turb. Oh, this light is terrible. Oh, this looks kind of good, right? Okay, let's do a wipe. Advanced wipe. Dalvik system cache data, but not the internal storage, because we have files on there that we need to keep. Otherwise, we cannot. We must go ahead and copy them again. So we go to home. Remember that this little button here that you will find on the MTP will help you to copy files from the computer to the device if, for instance, you got a brick and you cannot restore the device back, you cannot reboot the device again, you know. So then you can copy and restore back. Okay, remember that. This is very important to know about it. It will help you and save you a lot of stress. Okay, alrighty, so let's continue. We just did the wipe data factory reset, and now we're gonna say install. We first gonna install Lineage OS. I just went to the website and I saw that the 17th of December, I think that was today. So thumbs up, this thing is just fresh bacon. It's just done. So God bless whoever worked on this, for real, 100%. Just think of it, CM13 that is being updated, you know, for a certain device. This, what I'm doing now, this ROM that I'm flashing is only and only for this device. Don't ask me if you can flash it to another device. That is not possible. However, good news, if you have your own ROM and you have some other 10-inch tablet, that probably you can flash my mod. Okay, that's just a matter of trying. And as I said, if it, you know, if it's not working, you can just do a wipe data factory reset and just install the ROM again, whatever you were on. But you know, that is for different tablets, for other tablets. Tablets different than the Samsung Espresso Wi-Fi. That's the code name of this device. You see that? So now we just updated to the latest of the latest Lineage OS for the Samsung Tab 2. You see that? It's still busy. It's verifying the updated system image. This is very clever development, what is happening for this device. And I really appreciate it, you know? I appreciate it because these devices are still very, very good. They don't have 8 and 12 processors, but they are good enough. Trust me. They are good enough. Otherwise, these guys would not be wasting their time on an old tablet. We go back home and we go to install. And now this you could install on other 10-inch tablets. If you're gonna do it on a smaller tablet, then the Apple will only get bigger at the boot up, but the rest will work. So, you know, it depends on you. If you want to see a very big Apple, then you can also install this on a on a Samsung S2 bij wijze van spreken. So now we're flashing the mod. Installing the boot animation. And we're done. And now we're gonna reboot. So there we go. You see that? This is the Tab 2, the 10.1 inch. And soon we should get a little apple there. There you go. And it's booting up. This might take a second. After about 3 minutes of booting, we are now in the setup screen. Next, skip Wi-Fi's. We're gonna skip anyway. Oh yeah, of course, improve. Of course, we must help Lineage OS to improve. You don't have to do it, but I do it, okay? So don't you worry about me. We're gonna go for the Phone X launcher as always. And I hope that everything will go good. This is first time I'm testing this. Allow home to make pictures. Yes, allow. Otherwise it will not work. So we slide down. Oh no, not like this. We slide down like this. And it's loading. Takes a second to load. We even have the notch. You see that? Unfortunately, system. What? Hey, oh my goodness. Don't tell me that. I don't believe it. No, I don't. Oh, I thought you would let me down. Launcher. Don't you do that to me again, huh? Because I will get really pissed off. So here we can put our. You see the three invisible icons? I'm gonna put the camera a little bit better for you there. I hope you can see that. Here, just put them in a folder. They are invisible. They got invisible. And just put them somewhere at the back where you don't see them. There. Get your X tuned to the desktop because it's a nice icon that you would love to, you know, have close to you because it also has all your music and stations that you can listen music and you know, fantastic man. This one here is also nice. This will give you that we don't need. You see that? Nicer. And this is your home launcher settings. I would put that one, I would put it somewhere here. I would give it prominent place. You see? So you can always get to it. This is your Bitdefender. This is your sort of store. Okay. There we have one mobile market I saw. Hey, wait a minute. Oh yeah, the calculator is here. It's really big. It's gonna play in landscape, I think. No, you see that? Nice. That's a big calculator, yeah. Okay, let's close some apps. How to do that? I think. Oh, like this. No, we have no apps open. Yeah, this one here is open. Okay. All right. So this is nicer. Let's go into the launcher settings because we have more space here. So we can say dock. And we can set the dock space from 4 to 5. You see that? We say okay. We go one back. Can you see that all a little bit? I hope you can see it. If not, I'm very terribly sorry. So the dock we set to 5. The icons we can make bigger if we wish, because this is a bigger device. We can set that to, for instance, 65 or so. Okay. We can get a nice wallpaper if we wish. I think this one would be nice. Apply. Okay, and now we go back home and the launcher is gonna restart. You have given one app permission, access permission. Okay. I must give iNode permission, allow, and the tab X home, I must give permission. So now we also have iNode. You see that? Yeah, the notch looks a little bit weird here. So what I would do, if you want to keep the notch, you can also turn off the notch. Let me show that real fast here. You go here, you go one back, and here on top in the settings you can say turn off the notch, but then it still does not look good. I don't know what it is. The iNode just sucks a little bit. So what we're gonna do, it maybe it sucks a little bit, but not really a lot, because I'm gonna show you the good of this iNode. This iNode in fact is really good. You can say show menu settings. What was it again? Wacht even, what show status bar? Oh yeah, you can turn off show status bar and then you go home. And you see, now you don't have that ugly thing anymore, but you still have iNode. You see, that's nice, huh? You also have the dock. What was it called? Oops. You long press and then it comes up. You see that? This is it's really huge. Look at that. This, but it's nice. You can say whatever you want. It's beautiful, right? It is gewoon prachtig. Here we just made the dock a little bit bigger, so that means we can now also bring in one of the beautiful icons. We can, for instance, put the star in the middle. Oops. Kom eens hier, jij. Je moet even hier blijven. Mooi. You see that? I think this is very beautiful. I think many other tablets now are very jealous because on this tablet. What you think? Peeps. C'est belle or c'est pas belle? You tell me. Belle or not belle? I think it's belle. It's Bella like my Michelle Bella. So about the apps, yeah. The only thing that you must do now is go ahead and flash add-ons too. But this is the version. I already said I'm not gonna do all these things together with you. You must do that yourself. But here is Android 6.01. You see that? And security patches, Android security patch level November 1, 2017. You see that? And the build date was Sunday, December 17. Wow, I'm the first one probably worldwide showing this now at this moment. Amazing. I feel good. I feel good. Do, 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 do. So, about the root access, you know that you must flash add-ons too. For those that don't know, you must tap the build number until you became a developer. And you will have a tab saying developers options. And up here, you know, turn on your advanced reboot. That will make you kind of way faster into a recovery. You don't have to press no buttons. But here you're gonna see in root, that our root is, where is root? I'm not seeing it so good, the root. You see, we have only ADB. So I will have to flash it onto for Lineage OS 13, okay? And then I will have root access, and then I'm gonna go into my firewall. Where is the firewall? Hello? Firewall, where are you? Oh, there it is, prominent place here. It gives itself a very prominent place. And then you're gonna go and give permission to the firewall that you have root, that it has root access. Turn on the firewall, put whitelist to blacklist, you know, and start selecting the apps such as the standalone apps, such as the launcher. You can, you know, all those apps that I always show. I think if you already saw previous videos of mine, then you will know. But it will help you to save battery life, the firewall, if you block the apps, because they won't be able to communicate with the internet. So they won't send all these, you know, annoying things your way. So yeah, that's it, peeps. I'm not gonna make this video any longer. Go ahead and download the mod, the ROM. You will have to download from Lineage OS. I will put a link to the site. I'm gonna put a link not to the file, but to the page of this device, so you can get always the latest version that will be, you know, available. Otherwise you might get an outdated file, and that is not the meaning of this story. Only thing that will have another link, that will be the mod. And the mod you can then download and try to install on any other 10-inch tablet as well. That has a custom recovery and that is running Android 4 up to, yeah, 8 or so, 7. So check it out and give me some test results, and let me know in the comments if you like this project. If you did, give this video some love, give it a like. Before you leave, subscribe to my channel if you did not already. And I'd love to see you then in the next video. And for those that did not root their device yet, I have a video of how to do it, but I kind of failed to put the tools and to collect the tools. So I'm gonna take a look into that, and I will see if I can add the tools as soon as possible with a little description of how to do it. And but I think if you watch the video, you will also get a whole way. Okay, peeps, once again, thanks for watching, and I love to see you in the next video again. This was the iPad X Mod 4, the Samsung Tab 2, the P5110.